What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my kitchen, where safety is number one priority. And today I'm going to put to the test 10 Vantage cheese slicers. Let's see what I got this time. For the first gadget, this is a cheese slicer and at the same time a knife. So if you wanna slice up some cubes, you can go down this way, and then maybe even smaller cubes, you can go this way and this way into even smaller cubes. So makes sense, right? Works really well. Now you have a bunch of little cheese cubes. I like that. But also there is a little blade right here, and look how well it cuts. Amazing. You know what? I have put to the test so many cheese slicers like that. That was made in 2018 or whatever, the newest ones. This one is probably like 30, 40 years old gadget, maybe 25, but look how well it works every time. Obviously blade I did not sharpen, it stays sharp because you don't really dull out the blade from the cheese. I don't think so anyways. And it slices it like butter every single time. That's amazing. I love this cheese slicer so much. So far this is my favorite cheese slicer out there. And you know what the best part? Look how thin that is. Slice through cheese really well. Regular cheese too. This is so far, this kind of design cheese gadget usually never works that well for me. This one is the best. This one looks like a little bit newer compared to this one. Still wooden handle, but the spatula a little bit different. Does it say the year it was made? Nope, but it's only a dollar. It has to be like 30 years ago or something. For a dollar, a whole gadget, that's amazing. And it's brand new. Okay, let's see how well it's going to slice cheese. Ah, you see what I'm saying? You see, at the end, took off a chunk and sideways kind of slits too. And it's much thicker cut compared to the other one. Okay, second time turned out to be much better, but look at the difference. This one is so much thinner than this slice. One more time. Kind of go sideways like that, so that way it doesn't tear it up. Ah, slid off. Now I have to fix it all the way. You see what I'm saying? I used it 3 times, already had a bunch of problems with it. Okay, this time is a really good one, but again, compared to this one, I can go super fast. Not worried about it. Slice it so good, like butter, again. Because it does work so well. If I try to go with this one fast, you see it slides off at the end. You see? So, if I would have to pick this one or this one, 100% the older one. At least that's what I think. I think this is older one. Anyways, let me know in comments below which one do you like better. For the next cheese slicer, this is adjustable cheese slicer by pulling this and go up and down. So that way you can get really thicker pieces, or of course you can make it much thinner ones. I'm gonna try to do as thin as possible, because that's when it gets hard to slice cheese, whenever it's really skinny. So you put it down and then it just, oh, fail. So the idea is you put it down and then it's supposed to just roll. There you go. That was easy. One more. Will it roll? Another really good one. Easy. Wow. How thin is it? Much thicker than this one. Just a little bit thicker. Actually pretty much same slice. Maybe a little bit thicker. It doesn't go as straight, but as you can see, it works so well. And in case you want a much thicker slice, you can put it lower, adjust it, close it, and let's see what happens. Slide it and go through all the way. Nice, much thicker piece. Really, really unique adjustable slicer. I really like that one a lot. Made in Taiwan. For the next vintage cheese slicer, this is a knife with one of this wire inside of it. And also it has a fork at the end. Very strange and very unique cheese slicer right here. So obviously you can use it like a knife just by slicing it down like that. Boom. And then you can use it as a fork to lift it up and put it somewhere else. But what if you wanna slice it a long way like that? Let's see if it works. That wire kinda pulls on me sideways. But look at that, even the long way, it works pretty good. Kinda have to go slow, but look, now you have a really long cheese. You can slice it in half, maybe two, in case you want it for the sandwich, and use a fork again. And again, you can cut it up with cubes like that, too. Kind of that wire in a way sometimes, but such a strange and unique gadget. Look at that. I'll make another cubes right here. So obviously it works really good. Who does not like cheese? Boom, you have a tiny fork. Who is it made by? It is marked made in Japan, stainless steel. So this is very cool knife. You know they make really, really nice knives out there. For the next cheese slicer, I love this style slicer so much. Not so much the blade. I really like this one, the stone with one of these wires. It cuts so well. High precision. That's what I put to the test in last cheese gadgets. But guess what? I have a vintage one. Let's see when it was made in. Made in USA, 1 year warranty. I think it's already past due a long time ago. Doesn't really say when it was made in or patterned in. I wish it did, that'd be so cool. For those people who knows US pattern number, that's it. But anyways, let's open it up, see what it's all about. Looks like this cheese is already sideways a bit. Okay, now it's straight. Now I'm going to, with high precision, going to try to make super thin one. Ah, that was my fault. A little bit thicker one. And you know what's the best part? They jump away. Whenever you're done. You see how they stuck up so good? This is my favorite gadget. Apparently it was invented a long time ago. Maybe they just purchased the patent, or maybe it just expired after it's been so long ago. And anybody can make them. Not really sure how patent works for kitchen gadgets, but this is so cool. I honestly love this one. Look at that beautiful wood design. It has two different type of wood. Look at that tiny one. Oh, I skipped it a little bit. Oh well. You can make it thicker, skinnier, and look at this different stain. Or maybe it's like, yeah, it's like probably different stain or pattern. But there you go. It says do not dishwasher. So maybe it wasn't that old. But yeah, let me know in comments below how old is this cheese slicer. I really like it a lot. For the next gadget, I got another pretty old vintage cheese slicer. No more cutting. This one of these plastic cheese slicers. So probably not that old. But I love it that's already in the package and it tells you 4 ounces, 8 ounces pieces. And let's slice it up. My cheese is a little bit unique shape, so let's go this way, see if it's not going to break on me. It kind of wants to because it's just plastic. No wonder this one's didn't take off. Look at that, it's time to break, and this is very uncomfortable. I'd rather do it with a knife. Yes, it measures the 8 ounces and 4 ounces, but look at that mess. I'm done with it. good luck taking it out. Yeah, this cheese gadget doesn't really work that well. Look, it's so messy and stuck on it. Let's check out the next one. This is why it's much better to get very simple slicer like that with the wire and just chop them up. Look at that. Doesn't really cut all the way, so you kind of have to turn it a little bit, something like that. This is very, very unique. Let's see how well it's going to slice the thinner pieces. It's kind of hard to manage it, but as you can see, it does work. You gotta be really precise. Super cool vintage cheese slicer. For the next cheese slicer, I figured I will include it. This one is much newer one. I don't think it's vintage, maybe. Let me know in comments below. Anyways, let's open it up and see what it's all about. Thick and thin cheese slicer. On this side you got the thicker wire and thinner. And it's wide enough for us to get this big and long cheese. Wow, what an amazing gadget. I already can tell because it goes all the way through. This is the thicker piece. Nice. What about thin? Does it work as well? Let's find out. Just push it down and to the side. Super cool. Easy. That's definitely on the thinner side, especially on this side. Very nice. Let me do thin one more time. Just push it down and sideways. Very simple to use. Very fast. I like it. Thick one more time. Thick one is even easier. Boom. Let me know, guys. What do you guys think? Definitely works really well. Thicker size, thinner size, big pieces. Love this slicer. Definitely works and very simple. That's the best part about it. And for the next vintage cheese slicer, still in the pack. This article is for food use. It is complied with the provision of the materials and articles in a contact with food regulation in 1978. Wow, this is cool. So this is definitely a really, really old vintage gadget. And look at the packaging. The best. No plastic, paper. So what you would do is spin this open and then it lifts up the blade. Very, very sharp blade. I have no idea how to use it. There's not much instructions. Maybe I'm supposed to hold it like this or something. Let's try it. Maybe so, because it's even easier. At the end there, a piece gets chopped off too much. But oh well. Look at that, a thicker piece worked out good. Okay, let's see how well it's going to work on a thinner slice. Okay, that's really, really thin. Once again, I'm gonna hold it like this. Push it down, all the way down. Not cut my other finger. You know what, on a thinner slice, it works so well, paper thin. It's amazing. I love this gadget so much. And I think this is how you would use it. Is just hold it like this, put a couple of fingers in here, whatever comfortable, and just slice it down. I like this is the best, holding it like that. And again, very paper thin. And for the last gadget I got here, Wonder Knife for your kitchen with sharp razor. So instead of having a knife at the end, this is supposed to be a razor. So let's try to cut it. Wow, it definitely does cut really, really sharp. But I kind of would be afraid to cut myself with this razor blade. Does a really, really good job. One of the kind. I'm surprised with the packaging. Doesn't cover up the whole blade, only like half of it, so that way you have a chance to cut yourself. Interesting vintage gadget for sure. especially the packaging.
Well guys, that's pretty much it. Let me know in comments below what do you think about this video. Don't forget to thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.